Hello everyone, welcome back to the course. In the previous video, we saw that how we can remotely connect to a Raspberry and do the image capturing. But till now, we just did the image capturing with the normal RGB camera, or we can say that color. We took the color images or RGB images. And it's good if you want to monitor your plants and for example segmentation and so on. It's based on your purpose. But sometimes, for example, we wanted to measure the growth of our plant. So if you have the RGB camera, we will see, for example, the green leaves and the seedling, and we cannot measure the rate of the growth of your plant. For example, if we assume that this is the soil and your plant will grow toward the up, so we cannot measure the ratio of the growth of your plant. So for that purposes, you need to use some depth cameras. So depth cameras will send a signal to your object, and we record the reply of that signal as it will go and will hit the your object and will be back to the camera. So it will measure this distance of going the time of going this signal and backing and receiving from the camera. So by this, if you monitor your plants the time from the soil, so for example for the 2 weeks or 1 week, so at the beginning it's the soil, and then something pop up from the soil, and the camera will understand that okay, this is not the soil, something pop up, and so if you consider that the camera is here, your plants grows and become closer to the camera, the distance between the camera and your object will be less and less. And so if you have the full records of your image, you can find, for example, the circadian cycle on your image, or you can find the the growth rate of your plant during that period of time. We will back in more details how you can do this, but just in the case that why we need to use depth camera. So some available depth cameras, the low cost depth cameras in the market is the Kinect version 2. If you are a video game lover with high priority, you know that it's produced for the Xbox console. So it's under the price is around 300 euros. You can use another depth camera. It's Orbic, and it's almost the same price, 350 euros. Another option is using the Vico VR. It's more mostly used for the virtual reality projects. And it's around 600 euros. And also the last one, it's ZED. Also, this is one of the option for getting the depth images. So these cameras capture the RGB image plus depth images. So you can use both RGB and depth images and save it on your computer. So. But in this video, we will work more with the Kinect version 2, so with an adapter that we can connect it to a computer. And if I want to show an example here to you in a growth chamber, we have some tomato plants here from the beginning of their growth, and then we install the cameras. Kinect version 2 and one Kinect version 1. We install them and left them for 2 weeks to record the growth of the tomato plants. So, but we should consider that if we wanted to use these depth cameras, we need a USB 3 port. So the new version of the USB, it's not the new these days, but newer than the USB 2. So, but and then the, we need to transfer the data by our this USB. So, as we know, the Raspberry just has four ports of USB 2. So we cannot use it for the Kinect version 2. We can use it for the Kinect version 1 or Kinect 360, we can call it. We can use it for that, but if you wanted to use Kinect version 2, we should change our baby computers to another model that has the capacity of the using the USB 3. On the other hand, it will be good to use a Windows operating system on the baby computers for the Kinect version 2, as it is produced by the Microsoft. Kinect is produced by the Microsoft. It's work more stable on the Windows compared with the Linux. So, but anyway, you can also use it use the Linux or with Ubuntu or also Mac with the Kinect 2. There is no problem, but it's more easier to use the Windows for that. So for this, we have an option. It's a Latte Panda. It's another baby computer. The size is almost the same with the Raspberry, but in the Latte Panda, we have one USB 3 port plus two USB 2 port, and we can install Windows 10 on this. Windows 10, Windows 8, 7. So anyway, and also if you wanted to use Ubuntu or Linux, you can also install it on that. So it's from a it has more RAM compared with the Raspberry, so and also it has the Intel CPU and the GPU. It's not the GPU; it's just a graphic card, Intel HD graphic card. And so yeah, but it's more expensive than the Raspberry. So it's around $150 with the Windows license. So you see that because of the Windows license, the price should be much more than Raspberry. So, and then we can use SDK for the Kinect. You can easily download it from the Microsoft website and then adjust it based on your purposes, because the SDK that you will download is just for capturing the image or preview or maybe record the video, but it's not adjustable for your purposes. Maybe we wanted to have the time lapse, you wanted to change do some modification and so on. So, but just for the SDK, you can for the normal task, you can download it from the Microsoft website. As I said, it will capture a RGB image like this. You can take a skeleton image like this from the Kinect, and if you want to find the depths. Here you can see that I said that it's a skeleton, and you can see the depths. We can assign the color, can I show the color, I can say, to each object and see the distance based on that. Okay, so I will on the next video I will show you how we can use Kinect on the Latte Panda computer. How we can assemble it and how we can use it, and we will see a depth images on the computer. So just one point that I can mention is that if you wanted to remotely connect to the computer, to the Latte Panda, and your host computer is Windows, your task is much easier than the previous one. You can just need to enable the remote access on your Latte Panda in the system property. But if it's the home, it's Windows 10 home version of your of the Windows, the operating system of Windows, you need to download an app and make it enabled. But if you are use other version of Windows on your Latte Panda, you can just in your system property, you can just make it enabled to allow a remote connection to this computer. And then from your host computer, that's also Windows, you can just open the remote desktop connection and enter the IP address and the username and password of your remote computers, and you will connect to this and work with this. We will see it in the next video how easy is for remote connection to the laptop or the Windows and using that. Okay, that's enough for this video. See you on the next video. Thank you for your watching.